You know, that's one thing that you have to learn a lot. In IndyCar, when you draft, you save fuel. By saving fuel, you can go actually a lap further, two laps further than the guy that is in front of you. And that is a huge gain on a pit stop. So today, I was riding with the group and we got separated so we could do the shooting. And now actually the group, you can't see it, but it's right in front of us. And they're probably putting 300 watts. And I'm actually at 8 watts. Crazy Brazilians back here. I'm doing 40 k's an hour and averaging 60 watts, so we can keep talking all the way to town.
It feels cool, man. It's I love this vibe. Obviously, this is my decompress after my racing season. You know, I mean, I remember going to the last race of the year. We had a very tough year this year, and I couldn't wait to come here. So, feels awesome. I'm training a lot. Obviously, I'm not racing, so I don't feel the pressure, and I'm just enjoying my life. Well, that's very uncommon, right? We have a gym in Indianapolis that's called Pit Fit. It's actually a gym for race car drivers. We have a lot of machines and also some reflex exercises that I didn't even know until recently. Do you know you can train your eyes? Actually, you can have a workout for your eyes. So basically, that's what we do every morning from 8 to 10. And you can tell all the big names are there. Myself, Scott Dixon, Alexander Rossi. We have sometimes at that gym between 8 and 10 in the morning, you have four Indy 500 winners. And a bunch of IndyCar, you know, drivers that are trying to win and try to do our stuff. And we're there training so many things that people don't realize that we do. So it's a cool gym, very private. The way that Jim Leo does it, the guy that runs the gym, is from 8 to 11 in the morning, only race car drivers can get in. And after that, actually, it's open to the public. You can try anything that we do, and it's awesome. Well, people don't realize how hard it is to drive a race car. You know, you talk about driving for 3 hours at 240 miles an hour, 4 G's into the corners, the heat, you lose 4 to 6 pounds per race. They think, when you talk about driving, they relate it that you sit in your race, on your normal car, turn the AC on and the music, and so it takes a lot. So basically, triathlons, you know, they help me a lot. I do a lot of CrossFit, I know Talbot does it as well, because it's not just the cardiovascular part of it. You have to be strong, your neck has to be strong. Your shoulders have to be strong. Your core has to be strong. So it's more of a complete, you know, sport of as far as being fit. You got to do so many different things to be able not to have any issues in a race car. In a race car, obviously, you go to, you know, the safest and the best out there. And I use that on my triathlon too. So I love to look cool in a bike because I'm not fast enough. I love to look cool in the run because I can't run fast. On the swim, you just need a goggle, right? So to me, I pick on performance, I pick on aerodynamics, cycling, it's so similar to racing that I can relate anything on it. So basically, that's how I pick my equipment. As far as bike loading, I like something comfortable, but I really think you've gotta look cool. You've gotta look different, you've gotta look aggressive. On your helmet, I mean, if you see some images, I have my helmet painter from IndyCar, did actually the exact same paint, just a different color to match my bike on my bike helmet. So it's a state of art, and I love that kind of stuff. So I pick performance, aerodynamic, and speed. The only thing that I cannot pick that I haven't found yet, it's a pair of legs. So if somebody has a better one, I'll buy it. had to make a big family decision. My wife Lauren is from Indianapolis, but when I signed my contract with the new team, with AJ Foyt, the team is in Indy, I wanted to be more involved, I wanted to be more engaged. Although I could fly in and out of the, you know, from Miami to Indy, I decided that, you know, moving there, we're closer to the family, the kids can see their grandma, their cousins, and I could be in the shop every day. So huge, huge adjustment. I didn't feel that until we got to October. From October to February, when I was freezing and I had to do a lot of indoor training, which I've never done it in my life. I've been on my Zwift 4 or 5 hours a day inside. I feel like Sanders. By the way, thank you. Thank you, Sanders, because you inspire me to do that. You're my hero. And pretty much it's been tough. The winters are tough, but everything else, the city is awesome. I mean, the kids adapt extremely well, so we're happy. I think it's extremely important that, this sport gives me so much that if I can give it back to the sport, making the awareness on social media and being here present, trying to talk to fans, getting new fans to watch triathlon, and I get to train. I mean, it's a perfect vibe. So I keep coming back because I might want to do this again. So we'll see. All right. So I have so many friends, but I would go with Frodeno and Reef. I mean, I know it's boring. I know everybody picked, but you can't avoid the obvious. So that's my pick. Hey guys, I'm here with Talbot, and the man is working for free here in Kona. So come on, help him out. Shirts, hats. We're gonna put the link down. Go buy it to help the guy out.
Thank you.
I bought a bunch.